I'm with Lisa Herzog, a paleontologist at the North Carolina Museum of Natural Sciences, and the Dueling Dinosaurs exhibit, in many ways, has been in the making for about 67 million years, wouldn't you say? Mm-hmm. What is the significance of this exhibit?
Well, there's really two things that are really significant about it. One are the specimens themselves, and so it's two complete specimens. One's a Triceratops and one's a Tyrannosaur. That were buried together, which is an incredibly rare occurrence when it comes to fossils. And then the second thing that's really unique and important about it is that we built this exhibit and this lab to display them for the public.
Lisa, why is this called the Dueling Dinosaurs exhibit?
Now that's a good question. So because they were found not only close to each other, they're actually slightly overlapping in the ground. And because one is a predator animal and one is a prey, they were dubbed the Dueling Dinosaurs, in the thought that maybe they were engaged in some sort of battle, and that's why they died together. Research requires a lot of evidence if you're going to publish on specimens, and that's what we're doing. We're collecting evidence. You know, the research is ongoing to get a better picture of that kind of death scene.
When you visit Dueling Dinosaurs, you'll start by investigating the mystery of why these fossils are buried together. You'll learn about what these paleontologists have already discovered and the questions they still have. The exhibit includes 3D visuals, and you can even design your own dino in a virtual activity. Then, you're all prepped to talk to the paleontologists in the research lab, where scientists are actively studying and preparing the fossils.
I have heard nothing but good things about this exhibit, honestly. People are just excited to be able to come in and talk to an actual paleontologist. It really puts it in perspective what we do here at the museum. Particularly when they see up on the wall in the back of the lab, there's a video playing that shows us in the field, and people get really connected with us, that we're the ones doing that work.
Well, Lisa, it's a fascinating exhibit. I can't wait to explore it. Lisa took me behind the scenes to get an even closer look at what researchers are up to.
So this here is one of the our jackets that has part of the Triceratops tail in it. As you can see, it's mostly prepared. This is Nikki, one of our full-time fossil preparators, who is working on cleaning up some of the detail here. And Nikki works with us full-time, and she's also one of the people that sits at the front table over here to talk to the public about exactly what she's doing. And, you know, what we found from some exit interviews is that, you know, this process of seeing people working and being able to talk to them is inspiring people, inspiring kids, a lot of girls, to see, you know, science as a career choice for them.
Meanwhile, Aubrey is working on a process called histology, which helps scientists figure out what types of injuries these dinos had, and even how old they were when they died.
This is where we actually cut the bones in half and then glue them onto a slide and then polish it really, really thin so it's transparent to light. And what this allows us to do is see the internal structure of a dinosaur bone.
Remember, these paleontologists are making real-time discoveries, and even after you visit, you can keep up with everything new through their live stream cameras. You can find Dueling Dinosaurs at the North Carolina Museum of Natural Sciences at 11 West Jones Street in Raleigh. The museum is open Tuesday through Sunday from 10 a.m. to 5 p.m. And for more information, you can give the museum a call at 919-707-9800 or go online to naturalsciences.org.